Welcome back everyone to another tutorial. Today we'll be making this super cool banner for YouTube in Photoshop or Photopea. If you're not familiar with Photopea, it is basically a website where you piss on photos. Photopea is basically a full-on Photoshop that you can use straight from your browser, completely free of cost. Yes, you heard me right, it is completely free to use. Now if you have Photoshop, you can still follow this tutorial because both of them are exactly the same, and all steps apply to one another. And yes, you can also use Photopea on your phone, but it will be a little frustrating to use some of the functions. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So the first thing we will do is download the YouTube banner guide from Google Images. I will have it linked in the description below along with another link that will take you to a zip file containing some images which we'll be using for our banner, so make sure you download those as well. Once you have the guide image downloaded, go to File, Open and select your image. Then go to View and enable rulers. You can also press Ctrl R on your keyboard to enable rulers. Click and drag rules and place them around the safe area like so. This will help us keep everything in place so that they are visible on all display sizes. Next, go to File and select Open and Place. Select Background 1 from the Resources folder you downloaded earlier. Hold down Shift to maintain the aspect ratio and drag it to resize it until it fits perfectly in your canvas. Then hit Enter or press the tick icon. Press Ctrl J or right click on the layer and select Duplicate Layer. Then enable Transform Controls, click and drag clockwise while holding down Shift, then hit Enter to rotate the image. Give this layer a mask, select the Gradient tool, click and drag from the middle of the image. Now we have a cool red background. Alright, next we're going to import our other background image from the resources folder. We'll do the same as we did with the first layer by increasing its size so it fits the canvas. Change this layer's blending mode to overlay. Now we have a blend of two cool backgrounds. Don't worry if you think it looks too dark because we'll be doing color grading at the end, which will fix everything. Select the text tool, click in the middle and type in your channel name. Color doesn't matter because we'll be adding it later. Also make sure the text is centered. Select any font for now and increase its size so we can see it. With your text layer selected, go to Select All. Click Center horizontally. Go back to Select and then deselect. We're now going to import our custom font called Brotherhood. You know why I chose Brotherhood? It's because we're brothers. We're bros. Subscribe to PewDiePie.
Hey, stop! Why?
With the text tool selected, go to Fonts and load the font that was in the Resources folder. Search the font and select it. Let's increase the font size a little more. Make sure you're holding down Shift so you don't f*** up the aspect ratio, because only morons do that, so please don't do it. We're also going to move it up so that we have space for more text at the bottom where we'll be putting our channel niche info. Not a lot of people realize this, but having this info in your banner helps new viewers that come to your channel tell what the channel is about. Duplicate this layer and move it down. Type in your channel niche or whatever you want to add.
I'm not your dad, put whatever you want to put on there.
Decrease the size of both text until they look something like this.
Again, I'm not your dad, make it however you want to make it.
Alright, looking good so far. Now we're going to add some special effects to our text using layer styles. If you're enjoying this video so far, be sure to give this video a like and let me know if I should make more Photopea tutorials in the future. Double click the first text layer to open up layer styles menu. First, enable inner shadow. Change its blending mode to overlay and select white color. Make its opacity 50%, keep distance at 0, move choke or spread to 6% and size to 2%. Next, enable inner glow and change its blending mode to overlay as well, with 100% opacity and color set to full white. Make sure technique is set to softer and the source is set to edge. Make choke or spread 0%, size 11% and range 50% with jitter set to 0. Next is color overlay, also set to overlay blending mode with white color and 100% opacity. Now we're going to select our text color with gradient overlay. Keep its blending mode to normal and gradient style set to linear. Click the gradient and select the following colors. set the left color stop to EE2B2B, which is this light saturated red. Set right stop color to 360A0A and then hit OK. And close the layer styles menu by clicking OK again. Right click on the layer and copy layer style settings. Select the bottom text layer, right click and paste your layer styles. We're going to make this a different color. Reason is because it becomes very hard to read. At first glance, your mind wanders around and it can decide what to look at first. So we're going to change this one's color. So double click on the layer to open up layer styles and then go to gradient overlay. Select the gradient. Set the left stop color to 6 9s. Get it? 6 9s. 6 9. That's the 6 number. Okay. Set the right stop color to 6 4s. Then hit OK and change inner glow size to 5, then click OK to close the pop-up. We're almost at the finish line. We now just have to do some color grading with adjustment layers. If you have made it this far, head over to the link in the description and join my Discord. Now hear me out. In general chat, type in the code FF6A9. That's the orange color code, by the way, in case you're wondering. Once you've done that, just wait for my DM to arrive with a direct link to download this banner template. Stay in the server, engage with the community, and get more exclusive free templates from me. Alright, now back to the tutorial. First, we're going to make a brightness and contrast adjustment layer. By going into layer, new adjustment layer, brightness and contrast. Decrease brightness to about minus 110 and increase contrast to about 70. Next, create a curves adjustment layer. I won't be going into details how curves work because I honestly can't be bothered, the video is already too long. Create a point here, increase it to about there, create another point here, and move it to about there. Okay, cool. So basically what we did is just increase some of the contrast and decrease the shadows. That's all you need to know for now. Alright, next create exposure adjustment layer. Increase exposure to about 0.25. Offset to 0.033 I think will look good. And gamma correction to 1. Now go to layer, new fill layer and select solid color fill. Make its color to 4B90FB. That is this off sky blue color. Decrease this layer's opacity to 15%. Group all these adjustment layers we just created so far and decrease the group opacity to 70%. To decrease the overall intensity of the effects. We're going to create another brightness and contrast adjustment layer on top of the group with minus 30 brightness and 50 contrast. And that concludes our color grading process. But we have one more step to go through. We're going to create one more adjustment layer of hue saturation. With this, we can change our overall banner color with the hue slider instead of going into each layer and changing their colors separately. And we are finished. You just have to now save it as an image by going into File, Export, JPEG. Set quality to 100, export it and set it as your new banner. I really hope you have enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did, be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more videos. I also have more banner templates that you can check out in the end card. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Peace out. If I sounded weird in this video, that's because I'm a little sick. So I hope you didn't make any changes to the tutorial itself. So sorry, and why am I sorrying you? I'm the one sick. You should be sorry for me, right? Isn't that how that works? Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time.